Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX.
In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to create a lightning effect like Thor in Adobe After Effects. This is going to be very similar to my Electro lightning tutorial where I used ActionVFX free lightning assets to create the lightning effects. But for this one, we will be using other collections such as lightning beams and electric arcs, as well as a couple other collections to complement the shot. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so here we already have this keyed out plate of me. This tutorial will only focus on creating the lightning effects, so I will just breeze through here. Here we have the background that I originally got from Polyheaven. It was originally a 360 HDRI image that I unfolded using a CC environment. And then on top of the background, we have this atmospheric fog here that I want to turn to screen. And then I added this pre-comp of storm clouds from our storm cloud collections to fill in the sky. Then I turned the pre-comp to multiply towards the background. So now the cloud only fills in the bright areas of the sky. For the hammer itself, I have this other layer of hammer flying towards my hand very quickly, which combined with the plate, it looks like that I just called the hammer to my hand. The tutorial on how I did this flying hammer effects will be coming out next week. So subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification so you will not miss that out. Okay, so these are our plates. Now let's start adding our effects. The first effects I want to do is the glow effects on the ice. So let's get Mocha AE to our plate here and we want to track the eyeballs. On Mocha, I want to go to a good frame where I can see my eyeballs clearly. So this frame here just after the motion blur is good. And then we're going to draw a spline shape to the shape of the eye. And then let's track forward. Great. Now we cannot just do an automatic track backwards on the plate because the motion blur would confuse the spline track. So we're just going to track this manually backwards. So turn on the planar surface and then we want to move one frame backwards and then grab the middle point of the planar surface and manually move it. Okay, so now that we have the track, let's disable our planar surface and fix the shape of the mask spline. Great. And then we're going to disable the gear icon here. And then we're going to track the other eye. Basically, the exact same workflow. Okay, once we are done with the eyes, let's rename the layers. And then close and save. Next, in After Effects, we're going to duplicate the plate pre-comp here with the Mocha. And then on the Mocha, on the duplicate, we're going to go to matte. And on the visible layers, make sure that the eyeball layers are visible. And then we're going to create AE mask. And now we have transferred the shape from the Mocha to After Effects. And then let's add invert effects. And we have this interesting look. Next, I'm going to add tint. And on the black color, we're going to change it to something like blue. And then I'm going to add glow. And I want to set the radius to 35. And intensity to 2, and glow colors to AB colors. And then on the color A, I'm going to set it to light blue, and the color B to something a little bit more darker. And then let's duplicate the glow effects, and I want to set the threshold to 15, glow radius to 39, and set the glow intensity back to 1. Okay, and then we want to change the layer of our eyeballs here to screen. And let's feather the mask a little bit. And perfect. Okay, so now we have these eyeballs glowing. Let's animate the opacity so the eye glow only appear when the hammer landed on my hand. Perfect. Now let's do the lightning. Okay, so in both the lightning beams and the electric arcs collection, we provided you with both the elements with the glow and without the glow. You can use the without the glow version if you want to use the shape and generate your own glow effects. But for this tutorial, we will use the already glowing ones because the glow is already looking perfect. So let's drag this surface electricity here and turn it to add. And look at that, already looking pretty great. Now, of course, we want to have this electricity to follow my body movement. So we want to motion track the part where we want to add electricity to. And you can use the After Effects tracker, but for this, I will go back to using Mocha AE again. Back in Mocha, we want to disable the spline for the eyes and start tracking areas where I want to add the lightning. So here you can see that I have tracked several areas where the electricity will be, like part of my face, my body, my shoulders, my hand, and also the hammer. So now that we have the tracking data, we want to go back to After Effects and then create null, and then let's name it face null, and then transfer the data from the shapes to the nulls. So on the Mocha, let's create tracking data, and we are going to select the face. And then here I want to disable the scale because we just want the position and a little bit of the rotation, and then change the export option to transform and the layer export to the face null, and then apply. And we have our tracking data for the face. Now let's repeat this process for all the other tracks. Okay, so we have our tracking data. Let's start adding the elements. Let's start with my face first. Let's move our electricity from earlier to my face, and then we want to parent it to the face null. Perfect. So you can just leave this like this if you want. However, it would be much better if you want to combine this random electricity movement with a little bit of intention to it. For example, I want to have some electricity coming out from the eyeball. So let's find a good shape for the arc here, and then let's mask it. And then we're going to trim the duration of the layer because we only want to extract that one shape. And then of course we can bring another electric arc asset and start populating the face more. Another thing I did to add a bit more variation to the asset is to do some speed variation. So right click on the asset and go to time and speed it up to 75%. This way we have speed variations on the element. Okay, so this is the electricity on the face. Now let's add the elements to my body and the other areas as well. Okay, so we have our electricity here on my body, shoulders, hand, and the hammer. I also color coded them according to which null that the electricity belongs to, just to make it more organized. But it's not enough. I'm a big fan of pre-composing everything. So I want to pre-compose each of these layers' electricity groups separately. So let's pre-compose the electricity on hammer and its null, and then turn them back to add, and then pre-comp the hand and the shoulders together, and the body, and then the face. The reason why I separated them into different pre-comps is because I want to add additional glow effects later. And each of these elements have different thickness and scale, so if I add just one type of glow on everything with the same settings, the effects is not going to spread out evenly. So I separated them so each body parts can have their own glow settings. Okay, so now we have our electric arc cruising through my body. I want to add what I call the hotspot. But before we do, I want to first copy all the nulls from each of these pre-comps and bring them back to our main composition to be used later. So this is something that I covered on my Electro tutorial as well, which is when the electric arc is coming out and then connect back to the body, you want to have a little bit of bright hotspot right when the arc touches. And to do that hotspot effects is very simple. I'm just going to use this blurry white sphere PNG that I rendered out myself from just a solid being masked and blurred out. And I want to add this hotspot at the tip of the electric arc. And then I want to parent this hotspot so it follows the electric arc. So I'm going to parent this to the body null. So now that we have this white dot on my body. So next what I want to do is I want to trim this white dot so it only appears when the electric arc is there. And then basically we're going to repeat this process for every electric arc in the shot. Once you are done putting all the hotspot on all the electric arcs, let's pre-compose all of them. And then let's turn them all to add and fast blur to blur it out a bit. Next, I want to add another lightning. This time at the beginning when the hammer is flying towards me. So let's add this lightning beam off center here. And I want to make it look like it shoots out of the hammer. And then we want to animate the position so it follows the hammer. And then when it is back here, let's trim it out, and then I want to duplicate the lightning beam, and I want to make it look like it's shooting out from the other side. Perfect. Next, I want to add some lightning shooting out on my back. So let's grab another lightning beam, and I want to put this behind the plate, and I want this to shoot out from the back of my hand. So let's subtract mask this area here, so it looks like the lightning is connected directly to the hammer in my hand. And then I want to add another electric arc to make it look like there are some lightning on the back of my neck. Okay, so we have our lightning setup. What I want to do next is I want these lightnings to cast some brightness into the plate. So I'm gonna get an adjustment layer here and I want to add curve. And let's brighten everything. And then I want to create a mask around where the lightning would cast the light on me. And then feather the mask out. And then I want to duplicate the plate and I want this adjustment layer to alpha matte to the plate. So now that the adjustment layer is only affecting the plate and not the background. And then I want to animate the mask to follow the lightning and create another mask to brighten up other parts of the lightning. Basically, you want to make it look like my body is being brightened up by the lightning. Next, I want to brighten up the glow of the lightning elements. So let's grab a glow effects here and add it to one of our electric arcs. And then I want to just play around with the radius to brighten it up and spread out the glow just a little bit more. And then I want to copy paste this glow effects to the other precom as well and play around with the settings individually until we get the look that we want on each glow. Our additional glow effects is not super noticeable. In fact, you could actually skip this part of the tutorial and your lightning would still look great. That's just how easy to use this asset here. And then I want to add the glow to the lightning beam on the back here. But what I want to have is to have the lightning glow fall off on the back to wrap on top of the plate, even though it's on the back. So to achieve that, I want to duplicate the plate and then precom the duplicated plate with the lightnings on the back. And then inside the precom, I want to add a black fill to the plate. This way we have our lightning here obscured by a solid black color. And then let's go back to the main comp and bring this to the top of the plate. And then I want to add solid composite to even out the black background. And then we're going to add glow. Let's set the intensity and radius really high here and set the glow operation to screen and set the glow colors to A and B colors. And for the color A, set it to a light blue and color B a bit darker blue. And as you can see here, because we pre-composed the occlusion of the lighting, we have the glow coming out and wrapped on top of the plate. And then let's turn this pre-com to add. Okay, next what I want to do is I want to add a little bit more spread out glow that encapsulates the entire shot. If we look at our reference from the movie, you can see what the glow looks like. We have the bright white core of the shape, followed with a little bit of glow, and then on top of that is just a bright solid blue fall off that is spread out across the scene. So we already have the core, we already have a little bit of the glow. Now we want to add basically just the blue color on top. So let's create a solid and make it like blue, like the lightning. And then I want to set it to screen. And then I want to create a mask around the lightnings and feather it really big. And just like the light interaction, we want to animate the mask path and opacity to follow where the lightnings are. And then let's create another mask for the other lightning that is on the shot. And there we go. Next, I want to add some lens flare to really add the cherry on top. So let's get this icon lens flare at the beginning here, turn it to add, and I want to basically turn this lens flare into the hotspot of the lightning beam at the start. And then I'm going to add fire lens flare on top of everything to just add a bit more glow. Let's add hue and saturation and turn on the colorize, and we're going to change the color to something like a blue-ish and then increase the saturation. And then of course you can add some motion blur to the elements to match with the shot. And that's how to create a Thor lightning effects in Adobe After Effects. Once again, if you want to purchase the assets that I used in this tutorial, you can check out our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what you thought of this video or if you have other tutorial ideas that you would like us to cover. Most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also there are a ton of other resources on our channel, such as tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and so much more that we think you'll find valuable. This can be your home for visual effects content. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.